the Lord of Lords, the one that walketh in the ways of wind, the one that said, come unto me, all ye who labor and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. Holy Father, as we look into your word this morning, we invite the angel of God from heaven and the power of the Holy Spirit to come and be in attendance to teach us by himself, Lord, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Holy Father, we have sinned against you in our thought, in our action and behavior. Forgive us and look down from heaven in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We make a miracle for us. Bless us, Lord God of Israel, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Spirit divine, you are the teacher that will be led on earth by Jesus to teach us. So we invite you to come and be a teacher in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Today we are going to be looking at challenging faith. Challenging faith. Challenging faith. Father's inheritance and influence. You know, the seed we sow, we have tremendous influence on our children and upon their children. So today it is very, very important that we hear the word of God. And the word of God should have influence in our lives and life of our children. May the Almighty God bless us and bless the word we are about to receive today in Jesus' name. So today we are going to be looking at challenging faith. You know, everywhere you go as a Christian, the Bible never promises life devoid of challenges. It said, I will be with you always. I will be with you always. So what he's telling us that wherever we go, God is going to be with us. In order for God to be with us, we have to make sure that we are doing God's will and we are following God. But in order to do that, we have to make sure that we understand the word of God and that we practicalize it. As I always say all the time, God never blesses enemies. Challenging faith. We look at Psalm 112, verse 1 to 3. The psalm is telling us that the children of God, the children of God, they will be blessed. Psalm 112, it said, praise the Lord. How joyful are those who fear the Lord and delight in obey his commands. Their children will be successful everywhere. An entire generation of godly people will be blessed. They themselves will be worthy, and their good deeds will last forever. Their good deeds will last forever. So in order for God to actually bless us, we have to make sure we obey God's voice, we obey God's will. Doing God's will is challenging. But we live in the midst of a decayed world, that where people want to do whatever they like and whatever they want. And everybody wants to do what their mind dictates to them. And that's why you find that God is always angry with the human. But every time you find somebody obey him, Isaac followed the father's footstep. Isaac followed the father's footstep and they obey him. And because they obey God, Isaac obeyed follow the father's footstep, Abraham. Let us look at Genesis chapter 26. In Genesis chapter 14, God told Abraham, he said, I'm your reward. But he said, but God, I don't have nothing to show for my work, my service to you. You know, sometimes you may think you are not worthy because you may want to compare yourself to others. Abraham waited for 25 years and he felt he was not worthy. In fact, he was not blessed. He told God, he said, God, what is my reward? God said, I'm your reward. I am your reward. And he believed God. And because he believed God, it was counted to him as a blessing. So in order for God to bless you and I today, we have to make sure we follow the same principle. Sometimes when we look at other people, we may say, well, I think I wish I'm like that person. But when you get close to that person, you don't want to be like them because they may not be able to sleep in the night. They may not have peace of mind. They may not have joy. They may not have things we don't see that are blessing. And they may look that they are blessed by the car they drive, the house they live, the clothes they wear. But when you get close to them, you find out they have one problem or the other. So Isaac now is not in the shoe of his father. The shoe is in the other leg. The shoe is in the other leg. Genesis chapter 26. Abraham, we saw last week that Abraham is already out of the scene. He has fulfilled his generation. He's gone. Every now and then, we're all going to pass through the same road. One day, we're going to fulfill our own part, and we're going to leave. Genesis chapter 26, a severe famine now struck the land, as had happened before in Abraham's time. So Isaac moved to Gerar, where the Abimelech, king of the Philistines, lived. The Lord appeared to Isaac and said, "Don't go down to Egypt, but do as I tell you. Live here as a foreigner in the land, and I will be with you and bless you. I hereby confirm that I will give all these lands to you and your descendants, just as I solemnly promised Abraham your father, and I will cause your descendants to become as numerous as the stars of the sky, and I will give them all these lands. And through your descendants, all the nations of the earth will be blessed. I will do this because Abraham listened to me and obeyed all my requirements, commands, decrees, and instruction." So Isaac stayed in Gerar. You see, obeying God, may God bless you, what in Jesus' name. Obedience is where blessing comes from. Abraham has served God now, and the generation is gone. Now the son is on the scene, and the son is being told again by God. He said, "Stay in this land. Don't move." You know, sometimes when things are hard where you are, you may want to look outside. You know, today people are in the church. You see your friends who don't go to church, or who may be going to church, but they don't follow the word of God. They want to do whatever they want to do. But God is telling you, "Don't worry. I am your God. I am going to reward you. I am going to bless you. I am going to meet your needs." But your friend who is not a Christian is doing things that is ungodly, and you want to be like them. Isaac faced challenges. The challenge Isaac faced was, should I stay in this land? There is famine. There is poverty. There is hardship. There is difficulties. But you know what the Bible tells us? He said, "If you pass through the fire, I will be with you. If you pass through the flood, I will be with you." He never promised us life devoid of hardship, of difficulties. God never promised us that. But the Lord say, whatever you go through, how difficult you may face, I will be with you. But sometimes, you may hear some preachers telling you, if you're a Christian, you're supposed to say to the river, "Don't flow," and the river will flow or will not flow. You're supposed to say to that, and if you're not getting what you want right away, meaning God is not with you. Jesus never promised us that. He said, "I will be with you. I will never leave you. I will never forsake you." So here is a servant of God. The Father has served God faithfully, and the son is now facing hardship. He's in between. Should I remain here? Should I go? But the Lord told him, "Don't leave. Remain in this land." You know, this was the land that God promised Abraham and his descendants. When God promised this land to Abraham, Abraham never had any child. But God said, "Your descendants," God is looking to the future. God is now telling Isaac, "Your descendants." God is looking to the future. So, because of human condition, we're going to see challenges Isaac faced. So when the men who lived there, Genesis chapter 26, verse 7, when the men who lived there asked Isaac about his wife, Rebekah, he said, "She's my sister." He was afraid to say, "She's my wife." He thought they would kill me to take her because she is so beautiful. But sometime later, Abimelech, king of the Philistines, looked out his window and saw Isaac caressing Rebekah. Immediately, Abimelech called for Isaac and exclaimed, "She is obviously your wife. Why do you say she's my sister?" You know, the biggest disappointment for a Christian is for unbeliever to be correcting, telling you, say, "But I thought you were a Christian. But why are you doing that? Why you tell that to me? But I thought you go to church. I thought you guys don't drink. I thought you guys don't smoke. I thought you guys don't have extramarital affair. I thought you guys don't cheat." Well, you know why I was cheating? Because I needed extra money. May God help us in Jesus' name. We come against every demonic spirit right now that is fighting against us. We use the name of the risen Messiah to push back Satan's kingdom. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we bless you because your word is true. So then Isaac have challenges. Isaac have challenges. The challenge that Isaac had, Father, you see that Isaac had problem. The problem Isaac had was, should I leave this land? Should I stay in this land? But the Lord is telling him, stay in that land and I will bless you. Stay in that land, I will bless you. Isaac was having that difficulties, the choice to make. But he decided to obey the voice of God and he said, now, as he was there, he has fear. These people may not have the fear of God in this land. They may not have the love of God in this land. They may not love God in this land. What am I going to do? I am going to tell lie. I am going to cheat. I am going to tell people, this person is not my wife. And for that reason, he lied. And because he lied, the king of the country said, "Isaac, this person is definitely your wife. This person is your wife. I can see the way you are touching her, the way you are caressing her, the way you are playing with her. Sisters and brother, don't play like that." Verse 10, "How could you do this to us? Because I was afraid that someone would kill me and get her from me." Isaac replied, "How could you do this to us?" Abimelech explained, "One of my people might have taken her, they have taken your wife and slept with her, and you would have made us guilty of great sin." You see, great sin. You would have made us guilty of great sin. Then Abimelech issued a public proclamation. Anyone who touches this man or his wife will be put to death. You see, because when you think you are a Christian, you have to compromise, you are shortcutting your testimony. In order for God to bless you, you must learn to fear God all the time and to say the truth. The truth may not be fine. The truth may not be palatable, but you have to say the truth all the time. That's where the blessing comes from. So, Isaac, like his father before him, was thinking that these people don't have the fear of God. They don't have the love of God. They don't have God in their heart. And for that reason, he was afraid to tell the truth. Are you afraid to tell the truth when things seem difficult? Are you afraid to tell the truth when your friends are pressurizing you, or when you find yourself in the place where you're not supposed to be. Isaac told a lie. We may say what lie? Verse 12. When Isaac planted his crop that year, he harvested 100 times more grain than he planted. For the Lord blessed him. He became a very rich man, and his wealth continued to grow. He acquired so many flocks of sheep and goats and herds of cattle and servants that the Philistines became jealous of him. So the Philistines filled up all the Isaac well with dirt. These were the wells that had been dug by the servant of his father, Abraham. Finally, Abimelech orders Isaac to leave the country. Go somewhere else, he said, for you have become too powerful for us. When God is with you, your enemy will come to bow down to you. When God is with you, even in the midst of degradation, in the midst of famine, in the midst of hardship, the Lord will open the door for you. But in order for God to do that for you, you have to live in God's ordinance and covenant. God is looking for men and women who will obey him, men and women who will love him, men and women who will fear him, men and women who will do his will. Are you that person? Are you willing to live in God's covenant, God's command, and for God's blessing to be upon you? You see, in order for God to bless us, we have to be willing to pay the price of absolute honesty, absolute obedience, absolute love. Anything short of that one, then there's a problem. May God help us in Jesus' name. Finally, because of Isaac's word, you know, when God bless you, your enemy will be jealous of you. Your enemy will be envious of you. Your enemy will say, we don't want to befriend you no more. But the most person you want to befriend is God. When God is for us, who can be against us? The land was in drought. And because of Isaac's word right now, they are making conflict with him. You will think when you have money, people are going to love you. No, in most cases, when you have money, people want to fight with you. People want to denigrate you. People want to make sure they cause trouble for you. But the most important thing you need to do is to fear the Lord. May God help us in Jesus' name. So verse 17, Isaac moved away to Gerar village, to the Gerar valley, where he set up their tent and settled there. He reopened the wells his father, which the Philistines had filled up after Abraham's death. Isaac also restored the names Abraham had given them. May God help us in Jesus' name. Isaac's servant also dug in the Gerar Valley and discovered a well of fresh water. But then the shepherd from Gerar came and claimed the spring. This is our water, they said, and they argued over it with Isaac's herdsmen. So Isaac named the well Esek, which means argument. Isaac's men then dug another well, but again, there was a dispute over it. So Isaac named it Shitna, which means hostility. Abandoning that one, Isaac moved on and dug another well. This time, there was no dispute over it. So Isaac named the place Rehoboth, which means open space. For he said, at last, the Lord has created enough space for us to prosper in this land. Because things are hard for you in one area, doesn't mean you cannot move to another area. Sometimes God may want you to move from where you are. God may want you to prosper. God may want you to do things differently. So if you're in a place, you can pray to God. Is it your will for me to be here? And if you find that place is not comfortable for you, pray about it. And God may want you to move. But make sure that you are living in the will of God before you move. But if not, you can find yourself having difficulties. From there, Isaac moved to Beersheba, where the Lord appeared to him on the night of his arrival. "I am the God of your father, Abraham," he said. "Do not be afraid, for I am with you and will bless you. I will multiply your descendants, and they will become a great nation. I will do this because of my promise to Abraham, my servant." Then Isaac built an altar there and worshiped the Lord. He set up his camp at that place, and his servant dug another well. When you bring God into your business, into your life, into your academies, God is able to bless you. Isaac covenant with Abimelech. One day, King Abimelech came from Gerar with his advisor, Hazara, and also Pichol, his army commander. "Why have you come here?" Isaac asked. "You obviously hate me, since you kicked me off your land." They replied, We can plainly see that the Lord is with you, so we want to enter into a solemn treaty with you. Let us make a covenant. Swear that you will not harm us, just as we have never troubled you. We have always treated you well, and we sent you away from us in peace. Now look how the Lord has blessed you. When the Lord is with you, you are going to prosper in whatever you do. When the Lord is with you, whosoever is against you, they will fall for your sake. Right now, Isaac has been blessed. His enemies are coming to make peace with him. The Bible says, when God blesses you, he calls your enemy to be at peace with you. May God help us in Jesus' name. When the Lord bless you, he calls your enemy to be at peace with you. Isaac's enemy right now, they are making peace with him because the Lord has blessed Isaac. The Lord has prospered Isaac. Are you inviting God into your business? Are you inviting God into your affair? Are you inviting God into your family? The Lord is looking for men and women who will truly obey him, who will truly love him, who will truly fear him. But if you don't fear God, if you don't obey God, if you don't do God's will, then there's a problem. There's a problem. May God help us in Jesus' name. Today, God is calling people who will obey him. God is calling people who will love him. The world needs men and women who will stand with God so that God can use them to show his power on earth. May God help us in Jesus' name. Verse 30. So Isaac prepared a covenant feast to celebrate the treaty, and they ate and drank together. Early the next morning, they each took a solemn oath not to interfere with each other. Then Isaac sent them home again, and they left him in peace. That very day, Isaac's servant came and told him about a new well they had dug. "We have found water," they exclaimed. So Isaac named the well Sheba, which means oat. And to this very day, the town that grew up there is called Beersheba, which means well of oat. At the age of 40, Esau married two Hittite wives, Judith and the daughter of Beri, and Bashmat, the daughter of Elon. But Esau's wives made life miserable for Isaac and Rebekah. May God help us in Jesus' name. Mm-hmm. Today, God is looking for men and women who will truly, truly obey him, who will truly, truly love him. You know, you have to be very careful who is your friend. You know, Bible says, one's enemy are the members of his household. You cannot see that Isaac family, Esau, they're the one that's coming to make trouble with him. You want God to bless you? Stick with God. Obey God. Love God. Share God. Do God's will. Watch and see how God is going to manifest his power on your behalf. Unfortunately, it is very sad today that we want to be like Isaac. We want to say, well, I'm not sure the fear of God is in this place. You know what I'm going to do? I am going to just compromise. Are you compromising? Do not compromise. When you compromise, there is danger. The Lord is looking for men and women who will love Him. The Lord is looking for men and women who will obey Him. The Lord is looking for men and women who will fear Him. May God help us. So may God help us in Jesus' name. Today, God is looking for honest men, honest women that will do His will, that will obey Him, that will fear Him in Jesus' name. Are you willing to be that person? Are you willing to be that man? Are you willing to be that woman? Are you willing to stand in the gap for God in the midst of sin and degradation? If you can stand for God, it doesn't matter whatever you are going through. It doesn't matter the hardship you may go through right now. If you are on the side of God, you are going to be blessed. You are going to be successful. You are going to be abundantly blessed beyond your wildest dream. May God help us in Jesus' name. So you can now see that Isaac is not living in the father's inheritance, in the father's influence, in the father's wealth. As a father, what influence are you leaving for your children? As a son, what legacy, what inheritance do you want to inherit from your parents? Are you serving the God of your father? Are you obeying God? Are you expecting God to bless you? Do you want God to prosper you? In order for God to bless you, you must learn. You must learn to obey Him. Are you obeying that God? Today, God is looking for men and women who will obey Him. Men and women who will do His will. Men and women who will stand in the gap for Him. Are you that person? It is so sad that the word of God is not being followed by the children of God. A father may be serving God, but the children don't want to follow that God. And no wonder we're having a generation that are poor today. Children who are not serving the God of their father, rather, they are poor. Children who are not serving the God of their father, they are poor. May God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So today, they disconnect my line.
Okay. Right, I thought you were still using it.
How?
Because you're still talking.
So you find that children are not following the God of their father. They find that the inheritance of their father is not with them. But in order for us to have that inheritance, we have to make sure we serve the God of our fathers. Isaac is an example of a child who inherited the blessing of the father. What blessing are you inheriting now? Are you inheriting a curse? Are you inheriting a problem? Are you serving God at all? And if you are serving God, what is the relationship with your God and the God of your father? You know, enough for you to receive the blessing. You hear of generational blessing or generational curse. But enough for you to receive the blessing of your father, you must serve the God of your father. God will never bless his enemies. Any person that wants God to bless them, first of all, must learn to obey God, must learn to do God's will, must learn to follow God, must learn to serve God faithfully. If you don't do that, then you cannot expect God to bless you. Isaac obeyed the God of his father. The God told him, don't leave this land. Don't go to Egypt. Remain in this country. Even though there's a famine, he remained there. And you know what happened? He received the blessing. Do you want God to bless you? What are you doing to receive God's blessing? What legacy are you inheriting? What influence are you receiving? Are you receiving the God of your father's influence? The God of your mother's influence? Are you doing the will of God? And in what way are you doing it? One day, Genesis chapter 27, one day when Isaac was old and turning blind, he called for Esau, his old son, and said, my son. Yes, father. Esau replied, I am an old man now. Esau said, and I don't know when I may die. Take your bow and a quiver full of arrows. Go out into the open country to hunt some wild game for me, and prepare my favorite dish and bring it here for me to eat. Then I will pronounce the blessing that belongs to you, my firstborn son, before I die. But Rebekah overheard what Isaac had said to his son Esau. So when Esau left to hunt for the wild game, she said to her son Jacob, "Listen, I have heard your father say to Esau, 'Bring me some wild game and prepare me a delicious meal. Then I will bless you in the Lord's presence before I die.' Now, my son, listen to me. Do exactly as I tell you. Go out to the flock and bring me two fine young goats, and I will use them to prepare your father's favorite dish. Then take the food to your father so he can eat it and bless you before he dies." "But look," Jacob replied to Rebekah, my brother Esau is a hairy man, and my skin is smooth. What if my father touches me? He will see that I am trying to trick him. Then he will curse me instead of blessing me." But his mother replied, "Then let the curse fall on me, my son. Just do what I'm telling you. Just do what I'm telling you. Go out and get the goat for me." Verse 14, so Jacob went out and got the young goat for his mother. Rebekah took them and prepared a delicious meal, just the way Isaac liked it. Then she took Esau's favorite coat, Esau's favorite clothes, which were in the house, and gave them to her younger son, Jacob. She covered his neck and his smooth part of his neck and the skin of his with the skin of the goat. Then she gave Jacob the delicious meal, including the freshly baked bread. May God bless the word in Jesus' name. So Jacob took the food to his father. "My father," he said. "Yes, my son." Isaac answered, "Who are you, Esau or Jacob?" Jacob replied, "It is Esau, your firstborn. I have done as you told me. Here is a wild game. Now sit up and eat it so you can give me your blessing." Isaac asked, "How did you find it so quickly, my son?" "The Lord your God put it in my path," Jacob replied. Then Isaac said to Jacob, "Come closer so I can touch you and make sure that you really are Esau." So Jacob went closer to his father, and as he touched him, the voice is Jacob's, but the hands are Esau. Isaac said, but he did not recognize Jacob, because Jacob's hands felt hairy, just like Esau. So Isaac prepared to bless Jacob. "But are you really my son? Are you really my son, Esau?" he asked. "Yes, I am," Jacob replied. Then Isaac said, "Now, my son, bring me the wild game." So he ate it, and he then gave, "I will then give you my blessing." So Jacob took the food to his father and ate it. He also drank the wine that Jacob served him. Then Isaac said to Jacob, "Please come near a little closer and kiss me, my son." So Jacob went over and kissed him. And when Isaac caught the smell of his clothes, he was fully convinced, and he blessed his son. He said, "Hi, the smell of my son is like the smell of the outdoors, which the Lord has blessed from the dew of heaven and the riches of the earth. May God always give you abundant harvest of grain and bountiful new wine. May many nations become your servants, and may they bow down to you, and may you be the master over your brothers, And may your mother's son bow down to you. All who curse you will be cursed. And all who bless you will be blessed. May God bless the word in Jesus' name. You can now see that father's inheritance. Isaac had received the blessing of Abraham. Now he's now passing the same legacy on to the next generation. He's passing it on to the son, Isaac. Isaac is now blessing the son, Jacob. And Jacob received the blessing. As Jacob received the blessing, he's blessed. You know, sin can be very destructive. You know, Esau sold his birthright. Esau sold his birthright. When he was selling it, it didn't mean nothing to him. But now, the time to receive the blessing, you're going to see later on, he's going to cry. You know, sin can be very sweet for a little while. But at the end, it's very painful, it's very sad. I don't know what you are going through today. I don't know what difficulties you may be having right now and what compromise you are making. You know, the biggest exchange you can make is to exchange the worldly things of this world for your internal blessing, your heavenly blessing. Your heavenly blessing. That's what Esau did. He despised his birthright. He never appreciated. You know, Christ have died for us. You know, the birthright we have in Christ is eternal life. We are purchased with the blood. What blessing or what curse are you playing with? In order for God to bless you, you must remain within the covenant of the blood of Jesus. You must act honestly, absolutely honestly within that blood covenant. You cannot compromise and expect God to bless you. You cannot put your leg in the church and start doing things that are contrary to the will of God and expect God to bless you. God is looking for men and women to bless. Are you that person? You see, when Esau sold his birthright, he sold it for a pot of soup. But when he wanted a blessing, everlasting blessing, he cried, but did not get it. You may be playing today as a young person or as an old man. You may be playing and trivial with sin, but when it's time for you to reap the harvest, it may be too hard. When you serve God faithfully as a young person, when you are old, you will receive eternal reward. You will receive that blessing that God has prepared. Are you doing God's will? In order for God to bless you, you must obey Him. You must do the will of God. You must serve God faithfully. It's a must. But unfortunately, it is sad to say that most people are not obeying God. It is sad to say that most people are not obeying God. May God help us in Jesus' name. Amen. God is looking for men and women who will obey Him. So God, who will obey Him, may God help us in Jesus' name. Amen. As a child of God, we have an inheritance in heaven that cannot be taken away. We have an inheritance in heaven that cannot be taken away. May God help us in Jesus' name. So today, you find that instead of Esau, we have the God of Abraham, God of Isaac, and God of Jacob. Because Esau trivialized his blessing. When it was time for him to receive the blessing, he sold his birthright. What a sad, sad condition and sad, sad way of living. I don't know what you are playing with right now. You may be playing with sin. This sin may be sweet right now, but at the end of the day, it can be bitter when the time for blessing, when you really need it, you will never receive the blessing. So verse 30, as soon as Isaac had finished blessing Jacob, and almost before Jacob had left his father, Esau returned from the from his hunt. Esau prepared a delicious meal and brought it to his father. Then he said, "Sit up, my father, and eat my wild game, so you can give me your blessing." But Isaac asked him, "Who are you?" Esau replied, "It is your son, your firstborn son, Esau." Isaac began to tremble uncontrollably and said, "Then who just served me wild game? I have already eaten it, and I have blessed him just before you came. And yes, that blessing must stand." When Esau heard his father's words, he let out a loud and a bitter cry. "Oh, my father, what about me? Bless me too," he begged. But Isaac said, "Your brother was here, and he tricked me, and he has taken away your blessings." Are you playing with sin? Are you allowing the devil to trick you to take your blessing? Are you allowing the devil to trick you to take your blessing? The Lord is looking for men and women today to bless. Men and women to favor. Men and women to obey. Men and women to love. But they are playing with sin. And the devil is deceiving them. Not to serve God. Not to obey God. Not to do God's will. What a sad irony, and what sad way of life. Esau exclaimed, "No wonder his name is Jacob, for now he has cheated me twice. First, he took my right as the firstborn. Now, he has stolen my blessing. Oh, haven't you saved even one blessing for me?" Isaac said to Esau, "I have made Jacob your master. I have declared that all his brothers will be his servant. I have guaranteed him an abundance of grain and wine, and what is left for me to give you, my son?" Esau pleaded, "But do you have only one blessing? Oh, my father, bless me too." Then Esau broke down and wept. Finally, his father Isaac said to him, "You will live away from the richness of the earth and away from the dew of the heaven above. You will live by your sword, and you will serve your brother. But when you decide to break free, you will shake his yoke from your neck." You see that now a lot of people are playing with sin. They are playing with fire. They are playing with iniquity. But when it's time for them to actually receive that blessing, it might be too sad. It might be too sad. May God help us in Jesus' name. Today, God is looking for men and women. Men and women who will serve him, who will obey him, who will follow the covenant. But you know what the devil is doing? The devil is deceiving young men and women with the temporary things. Esau was deceived with a pot of soup. Esau sold his birthright. Are you selling your birthright to the devil? Are you giving away your blessing because of the monetary pleasure, because of the sins of this world? Are you giving away your birthright? That Jesus died for you. Jesus paid your price for you. What are you exchanging for that? What are you exchanging? Are you exchanging your eternal life for the things of this world that will not last? When we hear today, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Jacob, it would have been God of Abraham, God of Isaac, and God of Esau. But when it gets to heaven, when our name are being written, will your name be found in the book of life, that you have obeyed God, that you have served God faithfully? When we may say Jacob cheated Esau, are you disciplined? Are you easily swayed by the things of this world? Do you have hatred in your heart? Are you being deceived by the things of this world? Do you have hatred for the things of God? Do you hate God? If you do that, your blessings are far away, I'm sorry to say. But you want God to bless you, you must love him. You must obey him. You must follow all the commandments and rules and regulations written in the Word of God. Anything short of that, my brothers and sisters, I'm sorry to say, you are playing with fire. From that time on, Esau hated Jacob because their father has given him, had given Jacob the blessing. And Esau began to scheme, I will soon be mourning my father's death. Then I will kill my brother, Jacob. Are you having evil in your heart? You think your evil plan is going to succeed? Instead of Jacob to begin to plead with the God of heaven and earth, he is planning a scheme to kill his brother. Do you have a murderous plan in your heart? Do you have evil thoughts in your heart? And do you expect God to bless you, but you are planning evil? God is looking for men and women to bless, and in order for God to bless them, they must love him. But Rebekah heard that Esau's plan. So she sent for Jacob and told him, "Listen, Esau is consoling himself by plotting to kill you. So listen carefully, my son. Get ready and flee to my brother Laban in Haran. Stay there with him until your brothers cool off. When he calms down and forget what you have done to him, I will send for you to come back. Why should I lose both of you in one day?" Then Rebekah said to Isaac, "I am sick and tired of these local Canaanite women. I would rather die than see Jacob. I would rather die than see Jacob marry one of them. May God help us in Jesus' name." You see, a family that is divided or a family that does not follow the way of God, that part of the family can lose their blessing. You cannot see that Jacob was close to the mother, but Esau was far away. Are you close to your mother? Are you close to your father? Are you close to God? If you are far away from them, you are going to lose blessing, father's inheritance. Today we saw that Isaac followed the way of his father. Isaac obeyed his father and received the father's blessing. And the same God of Abraham, the same God of Isaac. So may God help us in Jesus' name. So you find that in order for God to bless you, in order for God to love you, in order for God to favor you, you have to love him. Are you loving the Lord? Are you serving the Lord? Are you obeying the Lord? But if you don't do it, don't expect God. Are you having evil plan in your heart? Are you close to the God of your father, the God of your mother? Are you obeying them? If your parents never serve God, are you establishing your own lineage just like Abraham did? And by Abraham's seed, God said, all the families of the earth will be blessed. And that blessing is transferred to Isaac. And Isaac transferred the blessing unto Jacob. We cannot hear today, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, and God of Jacob. What will be written about you when the whole story is being said and done? Would they say you are a good person? You are a faithful man, you are one who obey God? If not, it's going to be very sad when the history is written. For you to find that your name is not found among the record of prominent men on earth, and your name is not found among the record of those who are redeemed by the blood in the Lamb book of life in heaven. Your life would have been a wasted life. It would have been better that person was never born. But today it's never too late. You can give your life to Christ today. You can repent of your sin. You can serve God faithfully. You can obey him. And you can watch and see God bless it be upon you. Isaac obeyed in the midst of degradation, in the midst of famine, in the midst of strife, in the midst of trouble. God prosper and bless Abraham. I don't care where you are, what you are doing. If you serve God faithfully, in the midst of whatever you are going through, God can prosper you. God can bless you. God can abundantly favor you. But in order for God to favor you, you have to love God. You have to serve God with all of your heart. I always say, it's not what you do that makes God to bless you. It's not even where you are. It's not the country. It is the love and the blessing of God that makes you rich. May that blessing and richness be upon you, upon us, in Jesus' name. We are going to stop here today. And we're going to continue next week. And then we're going to continue in our challenging faith. I will now see that Jacob is away from home now. And he has gone to another foreign country. Is Jacob going to be blessed? Is Jacob going to stick to the God of his father, Isaac, and the God of his grandfather, Abraham? And if he leaves, if he go with this God, will this God bless him? We're going to look into it. Challenging faith. You know, every day, as we go about, we have faith that is challenging. When we mix with the public, when they tell us to commit sin, to steal, to cheat, to lie, are we following them? If we do that, there's a problem. May God help us in Jesus' name. Brothers and sisters, if you haven't known Christ, All this blessing is not going to be your portion at all. You don't have no relevant in this matter. But in order for God to bless you, first of all, to invite Christ into your heart, ask Jesus to be your Lord. Give Jesus your heart and tell him to bless you and watch and see God bless you. May God help us in Jesus' name. Invite Christ into your heart. Say, Jesus, forgive me my sin. Cleanse me from all unrighteousness and give me your life, which you have redeemed by the blood. And I give myself to you. Confess your sin and tell Jesus to be your Lord and Savior. You see, your life will be wonderful. May God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We're going to stop here today. Let us pray. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father God, I want to bless you for your word we have heard. Challenge your faith. Father's inheritance and influence. We saw because of Isaac, Jacob was blessed. Because of Abraham, Isaac. Because of Abraham, Isaac was blessed. And because of Isaac, Jacob was blessed. Father, because of Jesus Christ, we are blessed today. May his blessing be upon us. May his favor rest upon us. May his blessing be our portion. Father, any way we have sinned against you, by mingling with the world, by sinning, by conniving, by cheating, by lying, even just like Isaac, when he said Rebecca was his sister, obviously, unbeliever had to tell him. People that were not godly people had to say, you're not saying the truth. She's your wife. Why are you lying? Father, make us to be truthful all the time. When things may appear difficult, when we may be afraid that we're not going to achieve success because of one thing or the other, make us to put our trust in you as Isaac did when you told him, don't go to Egypt, remain in this land, I will bless you. And he sowed in that land and he put his confidence in you. He obeyed you, told him, as you promised Abraham, you are going to transfer the blessing to him, and he obeyed and he was blessed. Father, wherever land we are, bless us in that land. Wherever country we are, bless us in that country. Deliver us from the evil one. Let your favor rest upon us. Let your blessing be our portion. Anyway, we have sinned against you, forgive us. Grant us your favor, Lord God of Israel. Father, we prophesy. May your blessing rest upon us. Every hearer of this world, may your favor rest upon us. May Jehovah God be our God. May he bless us abundantly. May he favor us with the dews of heaven, with the riches of the nations. In the name of Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Father, we superimpose upon the physical. We say we are blessed. Our going out shall be blessed. Our coming in shall be blessed. May Jehovah God bless us and bless the work of our hand all the days of our lives. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say thank you, Lord, because you are Almighty God. We dedicate this word into your hand. As we hear it, we give ourselves to you as a vessel. Bless the Lord God of Israel and deliver from the evil one. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
May the Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Be magnified, O Lord, O God. You are the answer of every situation in our life. There is nothing you can do for us. Be magnified, O Lord. You are the exalted of every situation in our lives. There is nothing you can do.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
May the Almighty God bless us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We'll see you next week, same time, same place, in Jesus' name. Bye-bye.
Amen.